Hello Eagle Targeters, welcome back to our channel, where we consistently deliver the latest and fastest updates in the field of current military affairs.
The American aerospace giant Boeing has delivered its first F/A-18 Super Hornet Block III to the U.S. Navy. Consequently, the F/A-18 Super Hornet Block III is now officially a combat jet of the U.S. Navy. The Boeing F/A-18 Super Hornet, a twin-engine military aircraft designed for carrier-based multirole combat, is an advanced variant of the McDonnell Douglas F/A-18 Hornet. The F/A-18 comes in several variants, including the single-seat F/A-18E and the tandem-seat F/A-18F, both of which are enhanced versions of the earlier F/A-18C and D Hornet models. The Super Hornet is equipped with a 20mm internal cannon and can carry both air-to-air and air-to-surface missiles. It can also be fitted with up to 5 external fuel tanks and configured as an aerial tanker with an external fuel delivery system. Originally designed by McDonnell Douglas, the Super Hornet first flew in 1995 and went into full production in September 1997, following the merger of McDonnell Douglas and Boeing the previous month. The Boeing F/A-18 Super Hornet serves as a multi-role fighter and attack aircraft for the U.S. Navy. This new model retains some systems from the F/A-18CD Hornet. The F/A-18EF Super Hornet variants, used by the U.S. Navy, feature significant upgrades, including a 19-inch touchscreen cockpit display that replaces traditional buttons and knobs with a large tablet-like console. This touchscreen allows pilots to view, track, and target multiple distant objectives via a single tactical monitor with a 10-pinch zoom function. Another notable feature of the F/A-18 Super Hornet Block III is its conformal fuel tanks mounted on the fuselage, allowing it to carry an additional 3,976 liters of fuel, reducing aerodynamic drag and enabling longer, faster, and heavier loaded operations. The U.S. Navy plans to gradually expand its fleet of Super Hornets to 540 units, solidifying the jet as the backbone of its air superiority. Boeing secured a contract worth $4 billion last year to supply 78 units of the F/A-18 Super Hornet Block III, comprising 61 single-seat F/A-18ES and 17 tandem-seat F/A-18FS. All orders are expected to be fulfilled by 2024. Maintaining older aircraft can be challenging due to their limited service lifespans, often measured in hours. While these lifespans can be extended, this increases the risk of system failures, which is problematic for combat aircraft. The new Block IIIs boast a lifespan of 10,000 hours, compared to the 6,000 hours of the Block IIs, reducing such risks. One drawback of fourth-generation fighters in modern conflicts is their lack of stealth technology. Newer fighters like the F-22 and F-35 are almost invisible on radar, evading surface and airborne threats. Although the F-18 cannot match these advanced fighters' small radar cross-section without extensive modifications, Boeing engineers have made it more survivable. The specifics are classified, but reports suggest that the Block III Super Hornet is significantly harder to lock onto with precision radar, making it difficult for adversaries to target even if detected. Future battlefields will be inundated with information, with nearly every combat system interconnected and sharing data. The Block III's new distributed targeting processor network mission computer is crucial in this environment. Paired with the tactical targeting network technology link system, these computers can process vast amounts of real-time data, presenting only the most relevant information to the pilot. Despite these advancements, pilots will still need to interpret considerable data. The Block 3 simplifies this with a large 10x 19-inch touchscreen display, replacing the multiple displays and physical buttons of previous models. This helps pilots effectively manage the information they receive and respond quickly. The Block 3's upgrades enhance a proven technology. The Super Hornet has already completed numerous combat deployments in the Middle East and operated consistently in the Pacific and South China Sea. These improvements ensure it can continue these missions more effectively, without the challenges of a completely new platform.
Thank you for watching. Hopefully, this show can broaden the knowledge for you and your family. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to help grow this channel even bigger.